Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's create a script that will allow you to save and recall the positions of windows on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So the general idea is, say you've got some windows open, like I have a Pages window here on the left, and a Safari window here on the right, and you like this arrangement. You're working with this arrangement of windows and you'd like to automatically be able to go to this arrangement of windows, have them set to the same sizes and positions the next time you want to do this work. So it'd be great to be able to save them and then recall them. And that's what this script is going to do. So let's work on this in Script Editor, but we're going to move it to Automator before we're done. So in Script Editor, here's the script. It's not that long, but I'm not going to type it out for you. I'm going to have it here and we're going to go through it line by line. So the very first line is this one here, and it's going to declare a folder, a position for a folder that's going to be in your user folder, and it's going to be called window positions. You can call it whatever you want, but this is where we're going to save the files that are going to have the locations of all the windows. So it's useful to have this here at the beginning of the script just all typed out. Now, let's not forget to create it. So right now I'm going to go in the Finder here. I'm in my home folder and I'm going to create a new folder called Window Positions. So I've got that all ready to go. Now you've got a couple lines here that are standard for any JavaScript that you do. This is JavaScript, not AppleScript. You can see here I've switched it in the script editor. So this will basically take the first application, the one that's running in the front when you execute the script, and it's going to include standard editions, which means we can get access to all this stuff that we can script on our Mac. So now we get to work. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to go and get a list of all the files in that folder we just created. So the file list is equal to application-system-events.folders.byname with that file path, this path that we created right here. So we got all the files in there, all the disk items, files, folders, etc., and get those names. So now we have that in file list. We have a list of all the names in there. Now we're going to check to see if it's greater than zero. Initially it's not going to be. There's nothing in there now. So it is zero. But if it is greater than zero, then there's a file in there, at least one. Let's choose it. We're going to set a variable, which file equal to app choose from list, show the files that are in there, and then use the prompt with positions. The default item is going to be the very first one. And the cancel button, we're going to rename the cancel button as save cancel, because basically it's going to ask you to choose a set of window positions, and if you hit the cancel button then it will switch to a mode where you can save the current positions. Now if the results of that are no file, not which file, nothing has been chosen, then we're going to save. So you hit the cancel button, or the save slash cancel button as we've renamed it, or in the case where there was nothing there to begin with, this is the first time we're using the script, we're automatically going to go and call a function called save window positions. That's going to save everything out as a text file. Otherwise, we're going to go to load window positions. So a file's been selected. We want to set the positions of the windows. Let's do that. And let's pass in the name that was selected, the name of the file that was selected. So let's look at these functions here. We have two of them. Save window positions. So this is the one that's going to save it all out. First thing we're going to do is we're going to ask the user for a file name. So we're going to say, okay, prompt equals, and then display dialog, and ask what name we want to use, give a default there, and we're going to put this in a try catch sequence here. So if they hit cancel, so there's an error, then it's just going to return. In other words, the script's going to finish gracefully. Nothing's going to happen. You've canceled out and no action will be taken. Otherwise, we're going to put in a variable called positions name prompt.textReturned. So the text return from this prompt. Now we're going to go through and get all of the positions of all the windows. So we're going to start a variable here called save positions. It's going to be empty. And we're going to loop through everything. So we're going to get all the apps. App list is application system events.application processes whose visible is true. Only the apps that are visible. Then we're going to get the name. So we're going to get a list in app list of all the names of the apps that are visible. Then we're going to go and loop through them. So it's going to loop through them number wise. If there's 7 apps visible, it's going to go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're going to get the name of each one. So the app name is everything in the app list, get the number. So number 0, number 1, number 2. So say if you've got pages in Safari, it will first do pages and then do Safari. Then we're going to loop through all the windows. So the window list is get the application with that name and dot windows, the list of all the windows. We're just going to go through those by number two. So window num is going to be all the windows in the list. So if there are two windows, it's going to be zero and then one as you go through the loop. Then we're going to get the window, which window equals in the window list to the number. So window zero, window one. And which window is going to actually have all the properties of the window. So the name of the window, the bounds of the window, which tell us the location and width and height. Then we're going to add to saved positions, that variable we created up here that's empty. We're going to push a new element onto it. First is app and the app name. So pages, Safari, etc. Then window and the window num, so 0, 1, 2, 3. And then bound, which is the window and then this bounds property of it. So the X location, the Y location, the width and the height. And when we're done, saved positions is going to have this great list of all of the windows of all of the apps that are visible with the location and size of each window. Then we're going to save it out. So we create a file that is open for access with the original file path all the way back from the beginning of the script and the name that we chose. Set it to write positions. We're going to set it so that we start writing at the beginning of the file so it'll overwrite an existing file. And then we're going to write it out, app write, and we're going to write to that file that was selected and then close the file. Now we write out save positions, but not before passing it through the function JSON stringify. That takes the array that has all this information, this stuff in here, the name, window number, and boundary for each window. And we're going to write it out as a pretty looking string, one that can be saved as a text file, no problem. And then when we read it in, you'll see we'll convert it back to a regular JavaScript array. So remember now, if you chose a window name, then it, instead of saving, it called load window positions with the file name, so the file that was selected. So now we can open up the file and read from it the path, that same path we set at the beginning, plus the name. We have to put that inside of a path function here. And we are going to store the text from in that file in file text. And then we're going to use JSON parse, which is the opposite of JSON stringify, to convert from that nice looking text in the file back to an array that we can use in our script. So now we have save positions returned exactly as it was when we saved it originally. Then we're going to loop through each element in the array and get the data from it. So from save positions, each one, so 0, 1, 2, 3. Every window is there as a separate piece of information. And then we're going to get the application name from window. So that dot app property that we created back here when we made this array and said dot, you know, app. App is a property, window is a property, bounds is a property. We created that. So we're going to get the app name. So refer to the application. Get the window number. And there's that window property I just referred to. And then set the boundaries of that to the bounds part. So we're using app, window, and bounds from the original thing that we wrote out. App, window, and bounds. And we set it. So in other words, set that window to the original position that we recorded in the file. Now we have this if statement around here to prevent errors. Why? Because say you had three Safari windows open and you recorded the positions of all of them. And now you try to run this script again and set back those three window positions, but you only have two Safari windows open. It's going to try to set that third Safari window and there's going to be an error. So it's just checking to see if, hey, have we gone beyond the number of windows that we have here? Hey, we have three positions for three Safari windows, but we only have two Safari windows to check. So it'll do the first two fine, and the third one, it's just not going to pass this if statement, so it'll never try to set it. So it just prevents errors. And that's it. Let's go and try to run it, but just using the script editor here. So I'll save and I will try to run it. And I've got these windows saved here. And notice I'm also putting the script editor window here, right? So the positions of these three windows. So we'll run it. It's going to go and ask for a name. So we'll do test one. We'll hit OK. And it saved it out. Let's go and take a look here in the Finder. There is test one. I can select it and you can see there what it saved. And you can read what's there. App, Finder, window, zero, bounds, And there's the location of that. You can go through all this. There's pages, at pages, Windows 0, bounds. So we now have the positions from all the windows there. Let's try running it again. But before we do, let's mess things up a bit. Let's move this window here. Let's move this window here. And now this script editing window here is going to also be changed. Remember, it was like down here. So let's run this. And now it actually detects some files in that folder. Test one is there. Great. Do you want it? If I hit save cancel, it would prompt me to save another file. Let's go and just select this one. Now we can see it loads up those window positions and it sets the pages window, the Safari window, and even the script window to be in the original locations. So the next thing we want to do is we want to have this as a service so we don't have to open up the script editor to run it. So I'm going to select all of the JavaScript and I'm going to run Automator. And I'm going to create a new quick action, used to be called a service, in Automator. And in this, all I'm going to do is I'm going to set it to no input is received, works in any application, and let's search for JavaScript. I'm going to use the run JavaScript here. I'm going to select it all, delete what's in there, and paste in our big script. Then we're going to save. So I'm going to do file save, and we'll call it set window positions save. It's saved as a quick action. So now we can quit Automator, we can quit script editor, and now we've got here, go to pages services, we can see set window positions. So let's move these windows again here and we'll do services set window positions and it's going to run and say, oh great, there, test one. Get it. Now when you try this you're probably going to see these permissions when you first ran it in the script editor, but you're also going to see them here. It's asking, you know, is it okay? I was using Safari here and now Safari wants to go and set window positions. So of course you're going to say allow and it's going to do that for anything that's running. So you have to hit OK, but you only have to do that the first time. And notice all the window positions are now set back. The ordering's not the same, so this one isn't in the front, but all the positions are set back to where they were. So we can record a new set of them. Let's say I want to move these around and I want to put Safari on the left and pages on the right. I can now go pages, services, set window positions, and then I'm not going to select this one. I'm going to hit the save cancel button and call this test two. And it's going to save the positions for these windows. It's going to ask for permissions here. Again, only that one time. So now I can mess these windows up. I can go here and say services, set window positions, and choose test two. And you can see it puts it all back. And of course, now that it's a quick action, so it's in the services menu, I can go to system preferences. And then I can go to keyboard, shortcuts, services, and I'll find this here, set window positions, and I can add a shortcut. So I can do a keyboard shortcut that will do this for me. So this works best when you just have one window per app. You have a pages window, you have a Safari window. When you have multiple windows, you run into a little trouble because there's no way for the script to know which window is which. So if you have two pages documents open, you may end up with one and the other switching location. But even with that limitation, it's still pretty useful for a lot of people. Plus, this is a great example of using JavaScript for automation that may set you on the path to creating your own script to do your own thing. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.